at how to perform the timer based interrupt programming. So for this, let me open the project first. Interrupt example, open. So please understand the questions carefully. So here we are going to perform the timer based interrupt. In order to do the following, we are making the timer 0 as an event counter, and the event counting will be taken place with respect to the port 0. And again, here we are declaring the count as an unsigned character outside of the main function, which is a global variable. And we do have the separate timer interrupt function. So in order to count the value of the P0, so the P0 will be counted from 00 to the maximum value. And inside of the main function, so the count has been initialized with the initial value 0, and then we have declared the tmod is equal to 0x02, which means we are making use of the timer 0, and we are operating the timer 0 with the mode 2 operation, which is nothing but a 8 bit auto reload mode operation. So 8 bit auto reload means we are going to load the initial count value as an 8 bit that has been loaded in the TH register. Okay, so this since it is an 8 bit operation, so the maximum value is going to be a 256, 256 minus 46, which is nothing but a 210. So from 210 to the difference from the 210 to 256 is nothing but a 46 that we are trying to load it into the TH register in order to attain the frequency of 10 kilohertz. So what will be happening? So this 46 into 1.085 microseconds. So that will be giving us one time period. So that is 1 by twice that of the time period will be giving us a 10 kilohertz frequency. So in order to identify what is the meaning of a interrupt enable IE is equal to 0x82, you need to understand the interrupt enable register carefully. So in the interrupt enable register, we do have the this pin, D7th pin as high and D1st pin as high. So remaining all the pins you can ignore. Why? Because we are trying to enable only the interrupt, and we are trying to enable the entire interrupts, out of which we are going to utilize only the timer 0 overflow interrupt, which is nothing but ET0. That is interrupt enabled first bit, and we interrupt enabled 7th bit we are going to enable in the interrupt enabled register. That's the meaning 1000 0010, which is nothing but 82, that has been passed on to the interrupt enabled register of the 8051. And we are trying to enable the timer register as a higher time. We are trying to start the timer by passing on the value high to it. So each and every time, once if the timer overflow will be happening, the TH0 value will be copied into the TL0 register in order to perform the 8-bit repeated counting operation will be taken place by copying the value from the TH register to the TL0 register. So in order to demonstrate this, I am checking, is there any errors or warnings in my code? But there is zero errors and zero warnings in my code. So thereby I am going to start the debugging. So my code is running within the code size limit. So I am clicking OK. So in order to demonstrate for the user convenience, I am reopening the same thing again. So I am making use of the timer 0. I am making use of the timer 0. I'm making use of the interrupt. I'm taking the interrupt in my code. I'm making use of only the port 0. I'm taking the port 0. So in this, I request the students to listen to this. In order to operate with the timer 0 in the interrupt system, you need to select the timer 0. In the timer 0, first you need to enable the timer 0, and then in the timer counter 0, since we are making use of only the timer 0, and we need to start the timer externally explicitly. So here I am enabling the timer. So and if I click the run button, you can able to realize my P0 is counting from the 00 to the maximum value. Okay, so this is how the timer with the interrupt programming operates in the 8051. If you like this video, I request you to kindly like, share and subscribe. Thank you.